G'day viewers, we're back again from Australia. Well, where the bloody hell are you, as the campaign says? We'll put another shrimp on the barbie for you. Get yourself down here to Australia and have a ride with us. Okay, we're doing the Verreal RS 20 amp hour long range distance test on the all-terrain wheels. We're going to do a pretty quick one tonight. It's not going to be a long, you know, enduring one, but we're still going to try and get as much K as we can, give you guys an idea of what it can do. So let's head out, and I have got some... And that is Scott Davies.
Hi guys, how we doing?
He's in the house. Now,
so we've just been around into the bridge. Scott Davies is here.
Thank you.
We just ran into each other.
I'm out filming, he's out filming.
No, I picked him up. We're doing a sort of collab on my channel on this one, and obviously I'll be right down the track. So there's no argument, someone here witnessing this on the all-terrain Verreal 20 amp hour. We'll head off.
Going good, growing. Everyone's loving it. I'm getting lots of new subscribers, which is nice.
Yeah, yeah.
The engagement is really inspiring. It's nice when you can make a video and actually get people to not just watch a little bit, comment and like, and get involved and make discussion. It's really cool.
Yeah, you're doing well. You're killing it. Listen, we're gonna head off, and we'll get some amazing footage of the beautiful CBD Sydney on Thursday night. We're gonna have to Darling Harbour, across to Balmain, a little funky area. Have some dinner there. Pasta, so we'll film that. I know you guys like to, and so do we.
And I like to eat.
Yeah, so we'll see you guys. Let's get out on the road. Okay guys, dudes, put your helmet on, helmet up, as I always do. It's so important and critical in CBD Sydney. We're heading off, there's the Harbour Bridge. We're checking the first 5Ks and we'll check in with you then.
Okay guys, we're gonna set up map my ride. I know there's a few little bugs in it, but I like to use it. There we go. So we're heading out in the Verreal RS 20 amp hour long range on the all-terrain tyres. So here we go, start workout. Okay, that's a casino. Okay, I was gonna show you something. I've got the lights on tonight, which is the Steez lights. They're on very low setting. I've got double batteries. That's a ridiculous throw on that, but that's on low. I've also got the shred lights on the side as a backup light for emergency coming home. So that's gonna be a really nice look. We'll get the backlight on. There you go, so it just sits really nice like that.
Okay, we're heading off. It's gonna be a long night. We've got the 20 amp hour. Scott's got the Evian board. Scott's got the Evian board, and he's also doing a preliminary test on that battery. So we're gonna be sitting on speed 2, up to 34 Ks an hour, and we're gonna be stopping it each time. I've got the all-terrain wheels on the 150 millimeters, and also if temperature's about 21 degrees, it's our autumn, it's pretty crazy for the South Pacific region we live in. We're going through the CBD. So we'll check in, but basically, yeah, this is gonna be an awesome, epic ride. We'll come back soon.
Everybody.
Okay, we're checking in, first stop. It's a little bit dark here with the GoPro, but I think it might be okay. I want to get the backdrop in, it's so pretty. We're at 5Ks, make it really quick. We're still on high battery, 100% full, and it's been 30 minutes. We'll check back in a little while at 10Ks, and we'll see how we're going. See you then. Okay, now Scott's gonna have a ride of the RS. Now, Scott has reviewed the RS, but not the 20 amp hour, not with the all terrain. So let's see what you think, Scotty.
All right, let's see the difference. Oh, deck's different.
Yeah.
Different deck, right?
Yeah, completely.
Deck.
There you go. So Scott hasn't ridden the all-terrain with this deck before, and I'd like to know what he thinks. It's got a lot of punch and bite. This is a really nice board. This RS is literally the bee's knees right now. It has got to be one of the nicest boards that's come out of China in a long time. I just love it. It's literally not just bang for buck, it's just incredible torque, power, and this new battery, yeah, that's it, 50 plus kilometers. That's the shred lights are not on. That is the Steez lights at the front. You can see the throw on those. That's on low setting. You can see,
come on, are you joking? This is like a different board.
Really?
Yeah, 100%. From the RS that I had, the RS 1.0, because we had the very, very first ones.
Yeah.
With the different shaped deck.
Yeah.
This is a whole different skateboard. The different deck length actually works with those double kingpin trucks. The tires are so grippy and carvy. They feel as good as the best all-terrain wheels I've tried. Seriously, they're very grippy.
My God.
Very carvy.
You know, Scott, I have the same feeling. I mean, yeah, I've got the RS. I've got the RS with the tramper wheels, and I've got this, and I take this out all the time. So Vic has really done his homework. He's really listened to people.
I've ridden your tramper wheels, and these are better.
They are, I know.
In my opinion.
That's amazing. Sorry, Tramper, but yeah, these are a much better design.
Wow.
It's just the way they cut across the concrete beautifully.
They're beautifully quiet and grippy.
I know, it's like a BMW, it just goes
yeah.
It's just a beautiful board.
Wow. Good job, Vic.
Thanks so much, Scott. Awesome. Got some fireworks happening on the harbour. Just breathtaking tonight, look at that. This is Sydney in autumn, guys. You don't get much better than this. 22 degrees. Okay, we're just stopping for a quick little coffee break at this lovely, beautiful restaurant, Ruminiculous. Check it out. There it is. And you'll get the most amazing coffees here. Yeah, this board is just, it's just kicking butt. It's amazing. Just checking in, we're over the Anzac Bridge, we're at 7Ks, and I've lost one bar, so that's not bad. So 7Ks with a lot of hill climbs, and we've only lost one bar, so we'll check in at 10Ks and see if that one bar is still hanging in there. This is an awesome night, it's going to be fantastic. Dinner now, Italian and Balmain, we'll have a nice bite to eat, we'll check in. Checking in, Scott and I are having a burger at a pub. You can see it's the cricketer's arms. For those of you in America, cricket is a sport you play with a bat and ball. Okay, now, we're checking in.
And for the record, orange juice and diet coke.
We don't drink a lot. Well, I don't even drink.
No.
I don't even drink at all. Maybe that's why I'm so fit for 60 still. I don't know. Don't drink or smoke. Here we got one bar down. You can see there, 1 hour 27 minutes and 10 kilometers. So, yeah, looking good. We'll keep pushing on. We'll get back at 20 kilometers. I think we'll go straight to 20 and check in then. And I'll get some shots of Sydney now. Check it out. Let's just check out these Steez lights. Look at this. This is unbelievable. Check this out. That's nothing, and that's the Steez lights. Look at that. Unbelievable. Up this really steep hill here, it's at 30%, and the hill we did that lane was 38%, nearly 40% hill climb. The Verreal just made it up, going about 12 k's an hour. Let's check the motors now. What do you reckon, Scott?
Oh, they are like not even warm.
They're not even warm.
Like,
oh my god,
like they've been in the sun for 5 minutes.
They actually feel the outside temperature, it's 22 degrees, maybe even 24. Not even warm at all, not even one bit warm. There you go, amazing.
It's the beauty. It's the view of the 6368, they don't overheat.
Yeah, incredible. That was an amazing hill climb. I'm going to take a puncher on the long range, but let's have a keep going. Checking in, we're at 17 and Scott's verifying this.
Yep. 17 kilometers, two bars down.
Yes, and two bars down.
And I can tell you, we haven't been going easy. We've been in Balmain. If you know Balmain, there's so many hills.
We went on a hill that was just ridiculous. So
about 40%. Yeah, one of the biggest hills I've ever ridden up.
Yeah, exactly right. And the pressure on this long range, taking a very hilly suburb like Balmain, is important to show testimony of the cycle.
Everybody come along with me. We're gonna hit the
checking in. We're now at 40% battery. We're at 2 hours 20 minutes and we've covered 20 kilometres.
Check, sorry, I was looking at that.
So yeah, we're at 20 kilometres and we're down to 40%. A lot of hills, a lot of really heavy hills.
A heap of hills.
Yeah.
Way too many hills for a ranch test.
Yeah, true. But anyway, I want to get the best scenario, something if you're doing a lot of hills too. It's something a bit different. Okay, let's push on. Let's go through it. We're now at about 23 kilometers and I'm getting the first vibration on the remote, which indicates it's getting low, but that's because we've done a few hill climb tests on it as well. But that's okay. Still got 40% battery left, so we're still looking good. We're still looking pretty good. We'll keep pushing on. Okay. Checking in. Okay, checking in. We are at still 40% battery. We're at 25 kilometers and we have done 2 hours 47 minutes. So, yeah, those hill climbs are taking a bit of a pounding, but I'm going on the flat now, so hopefully that'll sort of balance out in the wash. Yep, so we'll push on and we'll go to 30Ks.
It is so nice not having to carry a camera for once.
I know.
It is so refreshing.
Scott is the hardest working YouTuber I know. And, you know, he, apart from me as well. And, yeah, it's so nice to see Scott out tonight just having fun and riding and verifying this long range test. We'll head back to the horse, the car. I don't want to run out of battery. But, yeah, looking good for 35, I reckon. It's not bad when it's still fun. Okay, I'm switching between. Scott's just here still. He's checking me. He's making sure I'm doing this correct. Okay, we're checking in. I'm switching between the GoPro and the iPhone because the iPhone has much better video footage at night time. So checking in, we're now down to 1 bar, approaching 27 kilometers. That's been corrupted by the hills. But that's okay, I'm just going to cruise along here, about 20Ks, that should balance it out, give you a rough idea. Anyway, we'll check in at 30Ks, and we'll see how we are going.
Okay, checking in. We had a bit of an issue, I forgot to resume the map my ride, so we're going to add 4 kilometres roughly to the overall distance, so we're up around 30Ks. So at the moment, the first vibration on 1 bar has happened, so we got 1 bar on the remote, and 1 vibrate, and it does say now 10% battery overall left on the board. And I know this board, when it gets to that level, you've just pretty much got to get within about 4Ks till empty. So they'll make about 34Ks all up, but we'll get back to the car, see what it can do. But 30Ks, 1 bar, and 3 hours and 15 minutes. Let's get back to the car, check it out.
Okay, checking in. We are at 33 kilometers, 33.5, and we're down to still 1 bar, and the second vibrate on 1 bar is saying I've got less than 10%. But that, to me, is still pretty good, so we've got a little bit more time. Yeah, let's get push on. I'll speed up a bit here now. So we're sitting on 35 kilometers, 10% battery left. We should get 38. Considering the hills at Balmain, 30%, this is an unbelievable result for this battery. We will just set back in when it's just about dead.
Okay, we're back. I'm on the GoPro. I'm here with Scott. Scott's still here.
Still here, hanging out.
Verifying up. Everything. So what happened? It actually died. But that's what this battery does. On this Verreal RS, fixed, not disclosed in the company, and what happens, the actual battery does go pretty quickly, and when it goes, it goes. But you get three warnings, and you get 10% warning, and you get 10% on one bar, and then it goes.
It so literally just stops.
It just stops.
It just glides so, to a...
So you gotta be close. So there you go, it's nothing left. So dead battery, how many kilometers? Well, we got on the clock is 30.5 kilometers and four that I didn't resume it from the coffee shop. Verifying by that, you can see this footage now in the top corner. Actually, I'll just play it. So you can see that that 4 kilometers add to 30.5. We're looking at 30, let's call it 34.5 kilometers. That's pretty spot on. And it would have done a lot better, but we did some big hill climbs, didn't we, Scott?
This was a massive stress test tonight. So you guys have probably seen my range test, which I have got inspired by Andrew. That one I did with B-Buff a few weeks ago, which was quite, it was off-road, it was grass, it was sand, it was, top speed, hills. Mm. This was even harder today.
Like
the hills,
I agree.
The hills around Balmain are insane. Like, look, it's so steep.
The Balmain area is very, you'll look at the graph on the finalization of the evaluation of the stats when they map my ride, you'll see the elevation. Yeah. Now, look, there's no point in going along just in a flat, straight area, going, oh, wow, we've got 50 kilometers or 40 kilometers. You need to test these things in a real world scenario. So we did today. I hope you're okay with that, Vic. I did test on some pretty steep hills, and I wanted to do that. So that result, 35 kilometers roughly, on these wheels, and my weight, 96 kilometers, I'm really impressed with that.
Yep, totally.
Really impressed. So I'm giving it a rating today of 9.7 out of 10, because of it didn't quite get the range I wanted, but then again, we balanced that out with the real-world testing of those hills. So I'm really happy with 9.7 out of 10 for this range on the RS 20 amp hour battery.
It's a beast.
Yeah. Thank you, Scott,
thanks
for coming.
Thanks for having me along.
Check out Scott's channel, link below right here, banner above, to his latest video.
And we'll get Andrew on my next video doing a range test on maybe the EO Van Carbon or the Propel four-wheel drive.
Yeah. And I've got a new board just arrived today. I'll be doing that next week. That's a mystery board. Very exciting. Carbon fiber, big kick-ass wheels. So till then, guys, thank you, Scott.
Thanks for having me.
It's now midnight.
We got a fist bump.
Midnight here in Sydney. Look at that. There's the casino right over there. So we're going to head home now. There's no one around. It's crazy, isn't it? Biggest city in the world. No one around.
No one here. Amazing.
Thanks so much, guys, for watching. Till then, happy skating, safe skating, keep carving. We'll see you in the next video.